Tanya Noor's mom. So today on Popular Demand, I am going to show you all how to steam or boil fruits and vegetables for your baby's weaning. So without wasting time, let's quickly see how I've cut vegetables and fruits, and then I will show you the steaming and boiling process. So let's see here. So I have cut vegetables here in flat, thin slices. So this is pear. As you can see, it's nashpati. It's so thin. This is pumpkin or butternut squash. This is the paka hua kaddu. This is apple. You can see how thin the slices are. This is potato. Again, thin slices. Sweet potato. Broccoli. These are just florets. Sorry for the brief interruption, mommies, but about a minute of my video unfortunately did not get recorded. Hence, there was like a slight break, which I realized later when I was looking back at the video. So, I am sorry, but I cannot do the video again. So, I'm adding this little chunk here. So, you all saw the kind of vegetables and fruits, how they're supposed to be cut in thin, flat slices. Now, I will show you two ways to cook them, either by steaming or by boiling. So, steaming is the preferred way of giving food to your babies because in steaming, the vegetables or fruits are not in direct contact with the water and they only get cooked by the steam that the water releases, hence preserving all the essential vitamins, minerals and nutrients. So, it is definitely healthier. And the recommended form to give babies cooked food. But I will also show you boiling because in some cases, when you don't have a steamer or you don't have the time, it's absolutely okay to boil foods for your baby. So what happens in boiling is that the vitamins and minerals, they also get inside the water in which they are being boiled. So the level of nutrients get diminished in those fruits and vegetables. Hence, steaming is preferred. But yeah, pressure cooking is not at all preferred unless you're giving something like your baby's quite old and you're giving something like a rajma or chola or anything else that really needs to be pressure cooked. So please avoid pressure cooking. Steaming is the way to go. But if you don't have a steamer, don't fret about it so much. Go with boiling. I myself boil sometimes when I don't have the time. So, I'm going to show you both in the following video and I hope I was able to bridge the two videos in between. So, now please go ahead and see how to steam or boil. Go back into the water. So, I'm going to show you both, how to do both. So, let's see here. Now, I have two pots here. Now this is like a jugaad steamer that I have made. Now if you see closely, this is nothing but a non-stick pan. I have added water in this. So this is already hot because I was making something for Noor. But let me add a little more RO water here. And this is a normal chalni or a sieve. And now this coincidentally fits the size, hence the jugaadu steamer. Now I place it over here. And I will say, for example, take the apple and just place it here. I will evenly spread it across and I will switch on the gas on full and just close the cover. So now this is steaming. Apple takes around 5 minutes. So by the time I'm telling you and showing you more, this will be done. So, if you guys do not have like a jugaadu steamer, then you can also use like an idli cooker or like the idli stand in a pressure cooker. So, all of that works. And there are also those steel steamers that come for steaming vegetables. You can use those also. So, this is one way steaming. Now, we're going to show you boiling. So, again, this is another pot. I will add water in this. I'll fill it halfway through. Now again I will switch this on and I am going to add say butternut squash or kaddu, paka hua kaddu or pumpkin to this. So I'm going to put it here and now this is immersed in water, whereas that was steaming, it was not immersed in water, but it is just cooking from the steam of water. So steaming is definitely preferred because it preserves the nutrients of fruits and vegetables. Boiling is definitely easier, but it's not recommended that much. But we all know that even I sometimes boil it because it's easier, it's faster, and this is too much of a complication. So whatever suits you works, but don't pressure cooker these vegetables or fruits, right? So now this is boiling, this is steaming. In the meanwhile, I can just show you these vegetables that I had shown you. These can be one of the early foods to start with for your babies, say starting from 4.5 months till at least the end of 6 months, you can just carry on with these. So we have apple, which is steaming, pear in fruits, then in vegetables, carrot, broccoli, sweet potato, there's pumpkin. You can also use beetroot. I don't have beetroot right now, so I haven't shown it here. Other fruits which need not be steamed or boiled are papaya and banana. So these are some of the foods that you can start with. Now a lot of you ask me about the quantity. How much food should be given to your baby. So now that I cannot tell you. You've got to do a trial and error. Start with a little. Feed your baby. If the baby wants more, you make more next time. So there's no set quantity. It's okay if your baby wants to eat more or less. It's absolutely fine. So now while these are steaming, I had previously steamed some apple in the similar manner and kept here. This is the steamed apple. Now I'm going to show you how I mash it. So this is the masher from Fisher Price, available easily on Amazon. So I will just take these steamed apple. This is a very small quantity and it's very simple. I just mash it like this. So it has grooves here, which makes it very easy and quick to mash. But even if you don't have a masher, you can use a fork at home. So see, it is so easy. It got easily mashed. So once your baby turns 6 months, it's advisable to move from purees to mashed food because the baby's has developed that much to eat mashed food. So if not, your baby is still not accepting mashed food, you can still puree them in the mixie. But this is how you mash them. And now these are some spoons that I'm using for Noor from Munchkin. And I'll just take all this mashed apple and put the steamed food in this small food pot for Noor. This is a very small quantity. Noor at least eats half of this pot. See, as you can see, it's absolutely mashed. You can add cinnamon to this while steaming if you want some flavor. And then I will seal it with the cap and give it to Noor when she is ready to eat. I usually make it like an hour or two before she eats so that it cools down also. These pots I have told you already before are from Mothercare. These spoons are from Munchkin. Now let's have a look at the apple. So this is the apple. Now let me quickly check whether the apple, see, it's almost soft. Just a couple of minutes more and it will be ready. You can test it with a knife or a fork. I'm going to cover it again. This is the pumpkin that's still boiling and this will take time and I won't be able to show you how it comes out, but it will be exactly the same. So you can either mash it or puree it, or if you're giving finger food to your baby, even do that. But the process of steaming and cooking or boiling remains the same. Here I'm not going to be touching upon the kind of foods for baby led weaning and the sizes or the textures. That will be a separate video, but this only shows you how to steam or boil fruits and vegetables for your little one. So this is almost done. I think it's around 5 minutes. It's almost done, yeah. So I'll just switch off the gas and I'm gonna take it all out again in the masher just to show you guys real time how it works. Here, and here is the masher again, and see how easily it gets mashed in less than 5 minutes and without destroying any nutrients or vitamins or minerals of the food. So this is ready. I would highly recommend this masher. Mashing from a fork takes a long time and I don't have that much of time, so this works best for me. So I hope this video was helpful. Next video will be on finger foods for baby led weaning. Till that time, keep writing, posting comments and suggesting topics for my new video. Thank you. Bye bye.